Now see, today we will start a new topic, chapter number 7. Chapter number 7, that is permutation combination and combination. See what is permutation and what is combination? What is the main difference between permutation and combination? Permutation is an arrangement. Arrangement of distinct objects. Okay? And combination is a selection. It's the selection of distinct objects from a given object. So arrangement, as far as arrangement is concerned, order is very important. Suppose two objects are given, A and B. Then AB and B are two different arrangements. But if you want to select out of A, B, C and D, only two of them. So selection of A and B or B and A are same. So in permutation, order is important. Matlab order does matter. And in combination, order does not matter. Here order does matter. It's important. Here order does not matter. Now before we start permutation combination, if you want to learn permutation combination, before that you have to learn fundamental principle of counting. What is the first concept of this topic? Fundamental principle of counting. What is fundamental principle of counting? In order to understand, let me give some example to you. Suppose, from Baroda to Ahmedabad, Baroda to Nadiad, there are three different routes. And from Baroda to Nadiad, there are three different routes. And from Nadiad to Ahmedabad, there are four different routes. A person want to go from Baroda to Ahmedabad. So how many different routes are available for him? See, every route so from Baroda to Nadiad corresponds four routes from Nadiad to Ahmedabad. So three routes from Baroda to Nadiad corresponds 3 × 4, 12 different routes. So person can select any one route out of those 12. He can have 12 choices. He can go from Baroda to Ahmedabad by 12 different routes. Why it happens? Because here one operation follows the other. There are two operations, or I can say two events. One is going from Baroda to Nadiad. Second is Nadiad to Ahmedabad. But one follows the other. So total number of ways are, total number of routes are 3 × 4, 12. Let us take another example. Suppose you want to purchase one pencil, one pen and one notebook. You went to a shopkeeper. Shopkeeper shows you three different type of pen, four different type of pencil, and five different types of notebook. You want to purchase only one pen, one pencil and one notebook. So how many choices are available to you? For pen, you have three different choices. For pencil, four. And for notebook, five. Right? But one follows the other, but the same person is going to purchase one pencil, one pen and one notebook. So here the event follows one another. And therefore, we are using word and. One pen and one pencil and one notebook. When and, you are using word and. Matlab multiplication. Matlab you are applying fundamental principle of counting. So total number of choices available for that boy or girl are 3 into 4, 12 into 5, 60 choices. Clear? But suppose two boys are there. One want to purchase pen and one want to purchase pencil. Then for one boy, three choices are available. And for another boy, four choices are available. But here one operation does not follow the other. So the total number of ways are 3 plus 4, 7. Here we don't apply fundamental principle of counting, okay? Okay? So for fundamental of principle of counting, the event should be such that they follow one another. Matlab they are in a order. Clear? Barabar? If in between or we are using, then plus. In between and we are using, then into. One pen or one pencil. So, plus. And matlab into. Now, what is fundamental principle of counting? It is given in your textbook. You can make it simple. If an event can occur in n different ways, and corresponding to each way, another event can occur in p different ways. Matlab one follows the other. Then, the total number of occurrence of the events are m into p. Right? So I can write, if an event can occur, or I can say, if an operation can be performed in m ways, and corresponding to each way, or instead of that I can write an another event. Can occur in n ways. One follows the other. Two events are such that one follows the other. Then, total number of occurrence. Matlab both events can occur together. The total number of occurrence are m into n. Total number of ways two events occur together are m into n. I can generalize this rule for more than two events. Suppose first event can occur in m ways. Second event occur in n ways. Third event occur in p ways. Fourth event occur in q ways. And one follows the other. Corresponding to each occurrence of first event, there are n occurrence for second event. Corresponding to each event of first and each occurrence of first and second, third event can occur in p ways. Then total number of ways are n into p into q. Then you can give example. For example, as I said, from Baroda to Nadiyat. There are three routes, okay? And from Nadiyat to Ahmedabad. There are four routes. Then total number of ways are 3 × 4. 12 routes. Clear? Because here I have to apply fundamental principle of counting. Suppose 5 boys. They have to form a line. Five boys can stand in a line. By how many ways? They have to fill up the 5 position. 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th and 5th. 1st position is filled up by any of the 5 boys. And, matlab into 2nd position is filled up by any of the 4 boys, because 1 boy has occupied the 1st position. Right? 3rd position is filled up by 3 ways, because 2 boys have already occupied 1st and 2nd position. So only 3 are left. Now 3 positions are occupied by 3 boys, so 2 are left. And 4 positions are occupied by 4 boys, so only 1 boy is left. So total number of ways a line can be formed are 23 × 36 = 120. Clear? Now this 5 × 4 × 3 × 2 × 1 can be also written as 5 factorial. What is 0 factorial? This is a definition. This is called 0 factorial. It can be read as 0 factorial. And 0 factorial is always 0. It is a definition we are accepting without proof. 1 factorial is 1, because 1 factorial is 1. 2 factorial is 2 × 1. So it is 2. 3 factorial is 3 × 2 × 1. 6. This is a short form, mathematical notation to represent the expanded form in a factorial form. 4 factorial means the product of 4 consecutive natural numbers starting from 4 reaches up to 1, or product of 4 consecutive natural numbers starting from 1 and reaching up to 4. It is one and the same. So it is 24. Same way 5 factorial is product of 5 natural numbers, 5 consecutive natural numbers starting from 4 and reaches up to 1. So it is 120 and so on. 6 factorial is 720. 7 factorial is 5040. Up to that much you remember orally. So this, how many ways a 5 boys can stand in a line are 5 factorial. Clear? So now, we can do few sums based on fundamental principle of counting and factorial. Clear? See, let us take sums from illustration. See, there are sum number 1. Clear? First sum is given is, how many 4 digit number can be formed by using digit 1, 2, 4, 6, 8? Digits given. Are 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. Okay? This is your example number 1. On page number 176. How many 4 digits numbers can be formed without repetition? They have asked without repetition of digits. without repetition of digits. But I can give you the answer for with repetition of digits. Second, we are adding with repetition of digits. Matlab, repetition of digits are with repetition of digit. You are given two questions and you have to answer both the questions. You are lucky enough. Here the digits are 1, 2, 4, 6, 8. 0 is not given. If 0 is given, then you have a problem, because in 4-digit number, if I put 0 on 1000 place, then it is going to become a 3-digit number. So when 0 is given, you should take care that 0 should not take position of 1000 place. Okay? But here, all digits are non-zero, so we don't bother. We have to fill up 4 position, okay? Unit place, 10 place, 100 place and 1000 place. Clear? There is no 0 in a digit, so we don't bother about last position. Now see, there are 5 digits. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there is no restriction given. Only one restriction. Repetition of digits are not allowed. So, unit place is filled up by 5 ways, because any of the 5 digits can be placed. Now, 10 place is filled up by only 4 ways, because repetition of digits are not allowed and one digit has been used by you. So, 4 ways. Now, 100 place is filled up by only 3 ways. Why? Because out of 4 digits, 5 digits, 2 has been used. So 3 ways. And last 100 place is filled up by only 2 ways. Because out of 4, 3 has been used. So only 2 ways. But here, one follows the other. So total number of 4 digits are 5, 4, 23, 60, 2, 120. There are 124 digit number can be formed by just using digits 1, 2, 4, 6 and 8 without repetition. Suppose repetition of digits are allowed. Then all 4 places are filled up by each place is filled up by 5 ways, because whatever digits I have used, it can occur again because repetition is allowed. So 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. So it is 625. Dekha? What a big gap. If repetition not allowed, only 120. And repetition allowed, there are 625 4 digit number can be formed. Because here 1111 is also there, 2222 also there, 2242 also there, 2224 is also there, while those numbers are not possible in first case. So if repetition of digits are allowed, we can have 625 4 digit number, and repetition of digits are not allowed, we have only 120 4 digit numbers can be formed. Are you clear? Now we are doing second sum. Second example from your illustration. How many 4 letter words with or without meaning of dictionary or dictionary order? With or without meaning, How many four letter words can be formed without repetition of letter? Meaning, without meaning. Don't bother about meaning. But repetition of letters are not allowed. How many four letter words can be formed by using the letters of the word K-E-N-Y. From this word, we have to take the letters. There are four letters, okay? R-K-E-N-Y in Kenny. And you are asked, without repeating the letter, how many four letter words can be formed, with or without meaning? So, here also I have to fill up only four position. First position is filled up by any of these K-E-N-Y. Second by any of the three, because already one has been used. Third position by only two ways, because two letters are used. And fourth position by one way, because three are used. So 24 words can be formed without meaning or with meaning. We don't bother about a meaning. It can be K-E-N-Y, it can be E-N-Y-K, right? Simple sum are given in the beginning. Then sum number 3. Third sum is, how many three-digit even number? How many three-digit even numbers? Here, even is extra. Even numbers can be formed by using digits 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 9. No repetition of digits. Here, this sum is little bit difficult. Because here, 0 is also there, which are going to create problem in making 3-digit number. If I put 0 on 100 place, it will become a 2-digit number. Not only that, it should be even. So we should bother about unit place also. Unit place is only filled up by 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Right? Only 5 possibilities for unit place. And out of that 5 possibility, one possibility is that 0. Right? So, two places you have to maintain. So, that is not possible. So, here there are two ways. You just count number of three-digit number. Three-digit number can be formed by putting on unit place 0, then by putting unit place, filling unit place 2, fill up the unit place by 4, fill up the unit place by 6, and fill up the unit place by 8. And then you add them. Or another way is, you just find out total number of, total 3-digit numbers can be formed. May all even and odd both together. And from that, you subtract all 3-digit number from that. So whatever number left are even 4-digit number. Even 3-digit number, okay? So I show you both the ways. Whatever is convenient to you, that you can use it, okay? See, we have to fill up three places because we have to form 3-digit number. Unit place, 10 place and 100 place. Clear? And digits are 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Puri decimal system. There are 10 digits in decimal system. All 10 you can use. So first I am showing you first way. Suppose unit place is filled up by 0. So one way. Then this 100th place is filled up by 0 has been used, so 9 are left. And 10th place is filled up by 8 ways because 0 and this 1 digit, 2 digits out of 10 are used. So only 8 ways. So you will be getting 72 even numbers whose unit place is 0. Now suppose you fill up unit place by 2. So one way. Then my 100th place, I have to remove 2 digits from this 10 because I cannot put 2 on 100th place because repetition of digits are not allowed. And I can't put 0 also. So for 100th place I have only 8 ways. Clear? I can put 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. But I can't put 2 as well as 0. Because I have to take care of both the places. For even unit place and for 3 digit number, your 100th place should be saved. It should not be put by 0. Otherwise it is going to become 2 digit number. And 2 places are filled up by 2 digits. So again 8 are left. So 64. Now whether I will put 2 or 4 or 6 or 8. These ways are remaining same. The number of 3 digit can be formed, which are even, right, by filling unit place by 2 or 4 or 6 or 8, it will remain 64 only. So total number of 3 digits, total 3 digit number numbers can be formed by using any of the digits 0 to 9 without repetition. R 72 plus 64 into 4. In between or. Here same. Clear? Same. Same. So my answer is 72 plus 16 carry 1 to 56. So it is 328. How many 3-digit number can be formed without repeating the digits? Let us check the answer, 328. This is one of the way. Another way is, find out, this is the first way to calculate. Now second way. Or, you find out total number of 3 digits without any restriction. Matlab only even. Sorry, without any restriction, even and odd both. So I cannot put 0 here. So this is by 9 ways. Right? So now 1 digit I have used here. Right? Here is 9 ways. No. Here I cannot put 0, so 9 ways. Now 1 digit out of 10 are used. So this is also by 9 ways. 2 digit are used, so 8 ways. So total 3 digit number, not even an odd, total. Total 3 digits number are 818,648. Now, how many are total 3 digit odd number? R. Odd number matlab, I have to fill up my unit place by 1, I cannot put 0 here, okay? Here 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So 5 ways. Now 1 digit I have used. So that digit I can't use on 100 place and 0 also I can't use. So 2 out of 10, 2 we are going to avoid. So this place by 8 ways only. And again 2 digits are used, so this is also by 8 ways. Do you get my point? Here 5. Out of 5, 1 I am using. So that one I can't put on 100 place and 0 also. So for 100 place, I have only 8 possibilities. Now, here I can put 0 on 10 place. So the digit which I have used here and digit which I have used on 100 place, 2 out of 10 should be avoided. So again 8 ways. So 8 5s are 48s are 320. So total even 3 digit number numbers form are total 3648 minus odd. So what is left? 328. Six forty-eight minus 320. So what is left? 328. My both answer match with each other. So both method are applicable. Whatever you like. But when you are given 0 as one of the digits and without repetition, even numbers are asked to find out, then you should take care. You have to take care of unit place also and 100 place also. If 4 digit, then unit place and 1000 place. If 5 digit, then unit place and 10,000 place. So we are not in a position to manage both the places. So for unit place, I fix up the digit. I go on counting different cases and add all the possible numbers of different cases. Or otherwise, you find out total number of 3 digits. Total 3 digit number can be formed. And from that, you subtract total or 3 digit numbers. So whatever are left are even 3 digit numbers. Because for odd, it is very, 0 will not occur on unit place for odd number. So only we should take care of 100 place, that I can't put 0 on 100 place. While in even, I can't put 0 on 100 place, but I can or I cannot. I can put 0 on unit place also, and I cannot put 0 on unit place also. If I can use 2, 4, 6 and 8. So, to fight with both the position is not possible. So, either you separately count the number of 3 digit number can be formed by taking different cases on unit place 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. Or otherwise, find out total 3-digit number and from that you subtract total 3-digit odd numbers, you will be getting total 3-digit even numbers. So are you clear? When 0 is there, you should be little bit conscious. Now again, if repetition of digits are allowed, and how many even 3-digit number can be formed are asked, then you can do it directly. Because when repetition of digits are allowed, then how many 3-digit number can be formed? See, repetition is allowed, huh? So here I can't put 0. So 9 ways. Here I can use 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. So 5 ways. And here 10 ways. Because repetition of digits are allowed. If repetition of digits are allowed, then sum will be very simpler. Because unit place I can fill up by either 0, 2, 4, 6 and 8. 10 place can be filled up by every digit other than 0. So 9 ways. And this 10 are 100 place. And 10 place it should fill up by 10 ways. We have to restrict 100 place and unit place. Unit place ke liye 4 alternative. 10 place ke liye 9 alternative, or 100 place ke liye 9 alternative and 10 place ke liye 10 alternative. So total are 95 jam. 450 even 3 digit number can be formed if repetition of digits are allowed. And suppose even is not asked, how many 3 digit number can be formed with repetition of digits? Then it is 9 into 10 into 10. So 900. So out of 900, 450 are even. So 450 are odd. Because out of 10 digits, 5 are odd and 5 are even. So number of even and number of odd 3 digit numbers will remain same. So are you clear? If repetition of digits are allowed, then sum will be very simpler. Neither you have to apply my first method nor you have to apply my second method. Direct principle of counting. Clear? Now let us start with next sum. Let us start with next sum. Sum number 4. 4 is given as a illustration, okay? I am doing illustration. Come on. How many 3-digit numbers are there which do not contain 2 at all? See, second, which contain 2 at least once and which contain 2 at most once? Here, repetition is allowed. Do you understand the question? Read it twice. How many 3-digit numbers are there which do not contain 2 at all? Matlab, which contain 2? Then second question, which contain 2 at least once? And third is which contain 2 at most once? Now see, you are given, repetition is allowed. Now you are given how many digits? Out of 10 only 9 digits are given. Because they have given digits like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have, 2 is not there. So we have 9 digits with us. Okay? Repetition is allowed. 9 digits are given. First digit can be any one of these. Now we have to form how many 3 digit number. So we have to fill up 3 places. 2 is not there. Unit place, 10 place, 100 place. You think over it. Repetition is allowed. Of digits is allowed. When repetition is allowed, my sum will be very simple. Now tell me, how many 3-digit numbers can be formed? I cannot put 0 here, so out of 9, only 8 can be used. Because 2 cannot be used in any place. We are given only 9 digits. Okay? So first, 100 places filled up by 8 ways. Clear? 10 places filled up by, there are 9. So all 9 can be used. Unit place is also filled up by 9. So 81 8 ja 648. How many 3 digit numbers can be formed? Total 3 digits number. Can be formed. R. 8 into 9 into 9. Now second question they have asked. First may 2 cannot be used. Second may which contain 2 at least once. 2 can occur at least once. At least once matlab one time at least shows minimum. 2 occur at least once matlab 2 can occur in one way, one time or 2 time or 3 time. Yeah, 3 digits or 3 time. So what to do now? Tell me. At least ka complement? None. 2 cannot occur any number of time. So 2 cannot occur any number of time. So those numbers are 648. Clear? In 648, 2 does not occur. But I want 2 can occur at least once. Clear? So first we find out total 3 digit number without any restriction. So we have 10 digits. 0, 1, 2 up to 9. So here I can't put 0, so 9 ways. And remaining by 10 ways. 900 total numbers. Total 3 digit numbers are 900. Where 2 can occur any number of time. No time, one time, two time, three time. Okay? So from 900, I have to subtract 648. So 2 can occur at least once. Then number, total numbers of 648. Sorry. 2 can occur at least once. Then total 3 digit numbers are 900 minus 648. So what is left? Subtract it. What is left? What is the answer? Tell me. At least once. So 252. Total 3 digit number minus 2 occur none of the time. Total number of 3 digits, total 3 digit numbers minus 2 occur none of the time. Then you will be getting 252 are the total 3 digit numbers where 2 occur at least once. Now third question is, at most 2 occur at most 1. At most 1 matlab 2 occur one time or none of the time. 2 occur none of the time is 648. 2 occur, what is question? 2 occur at most once. Right? At most once matlab one time or no time. Right? So suppose 2 occur no time, right? So that will be what? Tell me. Yes. Think over it. 2 occur at most one place. So one place or 2 occur at most one time, matlab 2 occur at one place or two place. Think over it. Try to understand. It is given as a solve. Look here, total how many? 900. In 900, you are given no time, one time, two time, and three time. Clear? So out of them, no time and one time, that we should consider. So two time and three time should be avoided. Clear? See, how do I count? Ek kiss, dusra kiss. See, I can put 2-2 in first and second place, or 2-2 on second and third place, or 2-2 on first and third place. Right? So 3-3, a one way, and this is 3 way. So 3-3 and 3. I can get 9 ways where 2 occur twice. Now 2 occurs once. 2 occurs 1 matlab 9. 2 occurs once matlab this is 2 occur 2s. Now 2 occur 3 times. So 2 occur 3 times, so 1 way. Yes. Total number of having 2 in at least 2 places, 2 places or 3 places. When 3 places 2 are there, then what are the total numbers? Yes, 1 ways. 2, 2, 2. So 1 ways. And this 9 ways case will be multiplied with 9, then another case 8, then 7. So 26 ways. 2 occur exactly at 2 places. R, this way 9 ways, then 1 way less, 8 ways, then 1 way less. 9 plus 8 plus 9. So 26. And this 1 way. So 27 ways. At least 2 ka aya, at least 2 time. Matlab 2 time or 3 time. So 26 and 1. 27 ways. So from total 900, I subtract 27. What is left? 873. So 873 numbers where 2 occur in at most 1 place. 2 occur in at most 1 place. At most shows maximum. At least shows minimum. Clear? Clear? First and second, second and third, third and first. And here three times, three, 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 9 ways. Then again, 8 ways. Then again, 9 ways. And all 3 places are filled up by 2, that is 1 way. So 8 plus 8 plus 9. So 26 and this one 27. So 900 minus 27. So 873. Clear? You refer from your textbook. Explanation is given very nicely. 2 at least 1s. So 252. 2 at most 1s means number occurring not having 2 at all. And number having 2 1s. Then numbers is 900 minus number having 2 in all 3 places, so 1, and number having 2 in exactly 2 places. Number having 2 in all places is 2, 2, 2, 1 only. And number having 2 in 2 places, but not all, are this 3, the blank space can be selected by 9 ways, then by 8 ways, and then by 9 ways. So number, the blank place can be selected in 9 ways or 8 ways or 9 ways. So 26. Okay. Now sum number 5. Now let us start with sum number 5. See, I think sum number 5 is very simple. You can do it by your own. Sum number 6 is also very simple. How many 5 letters passwords can be generated using first 3 letters as any of the English alphabet and last 2 digits are any digits from 0 to 9? Repetition is allowed. Look here. I have to form password. 5 places are given. First 3 places are filled up by alphabets. And remaining 2 places are filled up by 0 to 9. Repetition of alphabets and digits are allowed. How many password can be formed? See, repetition is allowed, so all 3 places are filled up by 26 into 26 into 26 ways. And this can be filled up by 10 into 10 ways. Clear? So total number of passwords, if you multiply, you will get 1,757,600. So 17,57,600. When repetition is allowed, nil, then it's very simple. That sum is very simple. Because there are 10 digits. I can use any of the digits here and here. So 10 into 10. And there are 26 alphabets. So first 3 places can be filled up by, every place is filled up by 26 ways. And one follows the other. Password contain all these 5 places. So it is 26 into 26 into 26, 10 into 10. Are you clear about how we can apply fundamental principle of counting? Now see, you are given 7.1. Exercise 7.1. Here all these sums are based on illustration 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If you have understood the illustration, I think you don't find any difficulty in solving exercise 7.1.